Let's see the first one. They just provided a parse method and main method. For the parse method, they're supplying invalid. So there is one string. For parse method, supplying a string invalid. Same string using to the parse float method. Parse float method. Then catch is number format exception. Then finally. So two methods they have given from a program. So don't copy this program and keep in the Eclipse and running. So that is in the worst cases. If you are not able to get any idea, then copy this portion and keep in the Eclipse without these line numbers. There are line numbers. They should be removed. So definitely most of the solutions required copying this inside editor or IDE, analyzing line by line, absolutely possible. So that is only the better, but don't go immediately. It's a simple program. Just observe one point. Float F, it is a local to try block. Float F, local to the try block. F is a local to the try block. How you can use in the catch body? Yes or no? F is a local to try block. Same we are using in the catch body. So you will be keep on focusing based on invalid. Invalid is a string. You will be getting parse exception. Yes or no? Number format exception. Just to observe, line number 13 is a part of the try body. Line number 13 is a part of the try body. Inside a try body, float F is equal to something. That F is a local to try. You should use within the body of the try. So try is getting over at line number 14. At line number 14 only catch is starting. Inside a catch body we are using F is equal to 0. F is a local to try. F cannot be used in outside a try. We are using F inside a catch body. You will be getting compilation error. Yes or no? Compilation fails. In the second example, try catch. Try and catch. So in a particular program, they just copied from line number 84 to the line number 92. There is a try with a catch. Inside a try body. Resource connection, results, then info, then close. Multiple statements are there in the try with a catch as one statement. Line number 90 is a catch. Then afterwards return info. Please observe, it is a part of the program, not the entire program. This cannot be copied into the edit place. This cannot be copied into the Eclipse. It is a part of the program. Mentioned line numbers also, line number 84 to 92 from a program. So one program which is containing some hundreds together statements, in that copied from 84 to 92. Then which statement is true? If resource exception is throwing at line number 86, at line number 86 there is an exception. They themselves are mentioning like at line number 86 there is an exception. If line number 86 rising an exception, then which options are true? If line number 86 raising an exception, then which option is true? Line number 92 will not execute. It is a wrong. Why? Because there is a catch to handle the same exception. Flow will become a normal. If flow is a normal, it will continue remaining portion. 92 is a end of the statement in this method. Control going to the end of the statement in this method. Then come to the option B. The connection will not be retrieved in line number 85. So exception is at 86. So 85 executing very successfully. There is no surety line. Connection will not be retrieved. Why? Because the statement executed successfully. Come on. The statement executed successfully. That is why control reaching to line number 86. So in the 85, completely results are positive. Connection retrieved. Come to the option C. The resource connection will not be closed on line number 88. So whenever exception occurring at 86, 87 and 88 both will not be executing. 87 and 88 both will not be executing. Yes or no? Both will not be executing. 87 and 88 both are not executing. Why? Because whenever exception occurs inside a body of the trial, remaining portion will not be executing. Remaining portion will not be executing. So that is why line number 8 is not executing, connection is not closed. Option C is correct. Come to the option D. The enclosing method will throw an exception to its caller. It is not throwing to its caller. Why? Because there is a perfect try catch. Raised exception object getting handled. Raised exception object getting handled. Getting handled. Yes or no? That is why it is not throwing. There is no delegation. There is no propagation. There is no ducking here. When there will be a delegation, propagation, throwing. If at all you are not handling. If you are not handling, then only it will be delegating. Option C is correct. Come to the question number 3. Please go through the question number 3. Come to the question number 3. They provided a skeleton of the program from line number 31 to the line number 38. They copied a portion of the program. From that portion, they're asking some questions. So in this portion, before try something is there. Try started at line number 32. Try started at line number 32. Then 33 is a body of the try. 33 is a body of the try. 34, catch. 35, catch body. 36, finally started. 37, finally body. It's only a skeleton of the program. No code is there. Only demarking. Before try, body of the try, body of the catch, body of the finally. After finally is a 37. 37 is some code here. Under which three circumstances will the code on line 37 be executed? Line 37 is some code here. Not after finally. It is a body of the finally. 37 is a body of the finally. Body of the final. In which three scenarios finally executing? In which three scenarios finally is executing? So line number 37 is a body of the finally. Line number 37 is a body of the finally. Yes or no? Line number 37 is a body of the finally. Body of the finally. In which three scenarios? In which three scenarios finally block will execute? Under three circumstances, which code, sorry, under three circumstances will the code on line 37 be executed? So let's see all. The instance gets garbage collected. See, there is a concept of garbage collection. Whenever garbage collection is happening, at that time, finalized method will execute. Only to confuse you between finalized and finally, they are given this option. You will come to know finalized method while covering object class. Under object class, there is a method called finalize. Only to confuse finalize and finally, they are given this option. First option nowhere related with finally block. First option is related to finalize method of object class. Only to confuse purpose. So remove option A. Then option B, the code on line 33 throw an exception. So whenever try body giving an exception, same is handling through catch. No matter whether it is getting handled through catch or not, once a control enters inside a try, finally will execute. Whatever exception rising at line number 33, no matter of getting handled or not, it will go to the finally block. It will execute finally. Yes or no? So come to the option C. The code on line 35 through an exception. Even though there is an exception in the catch body, finally will execute. Even though there is an exception in the catch body, finally will execute. Yes or no? Come to the D. The code on line 31 through an exception. The code on 31. 31 is something before try. Something before try. If something is happening before try, finally won't execute. If something is happening before try, finally won't execute. Option D is not correct. Come to the option E. The code on line 33 executes successfully. Assume try executed very successfully. Try executed very successfully. Finally will execute or not? Come on. Finally will be executing. So B, C, E are correct options. Go to the option, sorry, question number 4. Class A containing process method without a throws. Class A containing process method without a throws. B is a subclass to A. Inside a B class, process method overriding? Yes or no? Process method is overriding? Overriding? Yes or no? While overriding, throws IO exception. Whenever you are overriding a method, by using throws, you should not go for new checked. If superclass method is throwing, same you had to throw. While overriding a method, you cannot choose a new checked exception. If superclass method throwing any checked, same you can throw while overriding. Say here, A class process method not throwing IO exception. In the B class, while overriding process method, you are throwing checked exception. IO is a checked. Yes or no? IO is a checked. Checked exception. So line number 14 is not a correct. So line number 15 is super calling process method. That is okay. Line number 17 is throw new IO exception. This is also okay. Then in the main method body, what is there? Create an object to B, call process method. So inside a body of the try, we are calling process method. The catch, IO exception, SOP exception. So remaining all are syntactically correct. Only line number 14 not correct. So come to the options. Option A, exception, not correct. Option B, A comma B comma exception, that is also not correct. Option C, compilation fails because of an error in line number 20. Line number 20 is proper. Why? Because try with a catch is the line number 20 is very proper because of try with a catch. Try with a catch. Then option D, compilation fails because of an error at line number 14. Line number 14. What is there at line number 14? Line number 14, while overriding, choosing a checked exception. So option D is correct. Null pointer exception. It is not correct. Why? Because compilation error. Exception will come while running. But there is a compilation error. Option D is correct. While overriding process method, we are choosing a new checked exception. The same checked exception not available to the superclass method. Not available to the superclass method. Good. The question number 5. So question number 5, test method and main method. Test is throwing error. Inside a test method body, if true, throw new assertion error. SOP of test. Then main method, in the main method body, calling test method with a catch as exception. Then finally SOP of end, then main method end. Remember, test method throwing error. In the body of the test method, throw new assertion error. All are unchecked. Error is unchecked. Assertion error also unchecked. Compiler least bothering whether you kept a try catch or not. Even though try catch doesn't require, it will not be asking anything. And even throws error, compiler will not be giving any kind of syntax error. Test method absolutely proper. In the main method body, we are calling test method which is throwing error. We are calling test method in the try. Catch is with exception. So whenever exception is using in the catch, exception will act as unchecked. Exception is acting as unchecked. In the main method body also, try with a catch as unchecked. Compiler ignores. Syntactically correct. Come on. Compiler ignores. Why? Because catch with unchecked. Why catch with unchecked? Whenever exception is with a catch. Exception is with a catch. Then exception is a unchecked. So because of that, compiler not worry. So it compiles very successfully. While running, we are getting assertion error. That is throwing to the main method. Main method, line number 16. Line number 16 is a part of the try. But there is a catch with exception, no catch with error. Error cannot be converted into exception. I already said, integer wrapper cannot be converted into double wrapper. Why? Integer wrapper cannot be converted into double wrapper. But integer wrapper can be converted into number type. Integer wrapper can be converted into object type. Integer wrapper cannot be converted into double wrapper. All are siblings. Integer and double. Both are siblings. Both are derived from number. Number derived from object. Same way here also. Error cannot be converted into exception. Exception cannot be converted into error. Error can be converted into throwable. Exception also can be converted into throwable. So here, whenever exception occurring, it is not getting handled. Sorry. Whenever error is occurring, here error is occurring, assertion error is throwing, same is delegating to line number 16, it is a part of that, right? Unfortunately, catch doesn't have a error. What is there for the catch? Error cannot be converted into exception. Flow is terminating. End will not be executing. Yes or no? So what are the options? End no, compilation error no, exception end no. Why? Because end is executing. No. Exception test end. No. A throwable is thrown by main. Error is a throwable type. Error is a throwable type. Option E is correct. An exception is thrown by main. Error is not a type of exception. Error not a type of exception. Error is not a type of exception. Option E is correct. F is not correct. Understood everybody? Very important. Lot of points are there in this program. Compilation very success. Why? Because all are unchecked. Compiler least bothering. Compiling successfully. While running, assertion error rising. Same is converting into error type. Same error is converting into throwable type. Not the exception type. Not getting handled. Yes or no? Come to the line, sorry, question number 6. So here, if else and finally. If else block should not have a finally. Try catch block required a finally. Try catch required a finally, not if else block. So because of that, you'll get a compile time error. Compilation fails. Remember everybody, finally block should be after try catches. Finally block should be after try catches, not after if else. You can see if else finally, if else finally. This syntax is not supporting by Java. Finally block should be only after catches. That catches should be after try. So try catch finally, try catches finally, not if else finally. Yes or no? Compilation error. Move to the line number, sorry, question number 7. Question 7 also very simple, very very simple. Please observe. There is a try with two catches. Try with two catches. First catch taking exception, second one taking null pointer exception. First one is exception, second one is a null pointer. Null pointer exception can be handled through first catch itself. Observe everybody. Null pointer exception can be handled through exception itself. Second catch will never execute. Second catch will never execute. Assume inside a try, there is a null pointer exception. If there is a null pointer exception in the try, it will get handled through first catch. It will get handled through first catch. Yes or no? It will get handled through first catch. So second catch will never execute. Second catch is supposed to execute whenever null pointer exception is occurring. Whenever null pointer exception is occurring, at that time only second catch. That itself getting handled through first catch. I already said very clearly. If you are keeping multiple catches with the classes of inheritance, with the classes of same inheritance, what you had to do? Yes. From most specific to most generic. First subclass, then superclass. First subclass, then superclass. Then only compilation will be success. Otherwise, you'll get a compilation error. So we have seen almost the same type of example. Whenever you are giving multiple catches to the same try, First cat should have a subclass, second cat should have a superclass. Here it is opposite. The second cat will never execute. You will be getting compilation error. Compiler identifying unreachable. Compilation fails. Go to the question number 8. Guys, come to the 8th one. A class method 1 calling B class method 2, B class method 2 calling C class method 3. In the C class method 3, come on, line number 3 in the class C, there is a null pointer exception. At line number 3, more code here in the method 3 class C, there is a null pointer exception. Come on. They themselves mentioned very clearly like, there is a null pointer exception, there is a null pointer exception at line number 3, at line number 3 in the class C. At line number 3 in the class C, at line number 3 in the class C, there is a null pointer exception. There is a null pointer exception. So if that is the case, then what is the remaining content? There is like a other portion of the program. Assume like a line number 25 to 30. Line number 25 to 30, it is a part of the main method. It is a portion of the main method or some other inside your program. So line number 26, creating an object to A, calling method 1. Calling method 1. Assume line number 25 to 30 is a part of main method. In the main method, creating an object to A, calling method 1. Creating an object to A, calling method 1. These two statements are there in the body of the try. Catch is taking exception and SOP an error occurred. So where is the compilation error here? There is no chance of getting compilation error. Class A perfect. It is having a method 1. It is creating an object to B, calling method 2. Inside a class B, method 2, creating an object to C, calling method 3. In the method 3, they themselves mentioned like it, there is a null pointer exception. That null pointer exception will be propagating to method 2 of class B. From there, propagating to method 1 of class A. From there, propagating to line number 27. Come on. Line number 27 giving a call to method 1 of class A. Method 1 of class A giving a call to method 2 of class B. Method 2 of the class B giving a call to method 3 of class C. Method 3 of the class A rising null pointer exception. Sir, now that is throwing to B. B is throwing to A. A is throwing to main method. Assume line number 27 is a part of the main method. It is a null pointer exception. Yes or no? Control reaching to 27. Null pointer exception. Same null pointer exception can be handled through exception. Yes or no? Line number 28. Catch. Control goes to line number 29. You will be getting output as a line number 29. Flow is continuing. Flow is continuing. Flow will become a normal. Why flow is a normal? Whatever exception rise, the same is getting handled. Yes or no? So let's see the options. The application will crash. When application will crash? Whenever exception object is not getting handled. Whenever exception object is not getting handled, application will be crashing. Flow termination is nothing but application crashing. Flow termination is nothing but application crashing. So we hear flow will not be terminated. Why flow is not terminating? Flow is not terminating. Why? exception object getting handled in the main method body. So come to the B. The code on line 29 will not be executed. What is 29? 29 will execute properly. Why? Because control reaching to the catch to handle null band exception. Is or no? Option C. The code on line 5 of class A will execute. See here, if exception object is occurring, the flow will be, whenever exception object is returning from method 2, same exception object will be returning to the main method. The portion, remaining portion of the method 1 will not be executing. Is or no? Practically I showed. Is or no?
Yes, sir.
So here, line number 5 will not be executing in the class A. Why? Because line number 4 is receiving a unhandled exception object. It is not getting handled at line number 4. It will be delegating to caller of method 1. Is or no? Option D. Option D. The code on line 5 of class B will execute. Same holds good here also. Why? Because C. Option C. Sorry. Class C method 3. Class C method 3. Class C method 3. Class C method 3. Throwing an exception. Well, it is throwing an exception to method B. Sorry. Method 2 in the class B. Remaining portion will not be executing. In the class A, line number 5 won't execute. In the class B, line number 5 won't execute. Sir, no. Come to the E. The exception will be propagated back to line number 27. Exception propagating back to line number 27. We have seen very clearly. Raised exception are getting handled in the method 3, in the method 2, in the method 1. Propagating to caller of method 1. Who is the caller of method 1? Line number 27. Line number 27. Yes or no? We are assuming line number 25 to 30 is a part of the main method. Yes or no? So B and E both are correct. B and E both are correct. Come to the ninth one. Guys, ninth one. Test method throwing runtime exception. Say try SOP throw new runtime exception. After runtime exception, there is a catch exception. So test method syntactically correct. Test method syntactically correct. Yes or no? Throws runtime exception. Try throw new runtime exception, then catch. Absolutely possible. Proper also. Throw new runtime exception. It is a unchecked exception. So catch with exception. It is also unchecked. Then come to the main method. In the main method body, try with a test, catch runtime exception, SOP of runtime, so catch end. So here, see in the main method body, giving a call to test method, giving a call to test method. So how we are calling test method in the body of the try? There is a catch of runtime exception. SOP of runtime, SOP of end. Please observe, in the test method body, runtime exception, SOP of test, runtime exception, say catch exception, SOP of exception. So all are very proper. There is no place where you will get a compile time error. All are unchecked. Compiler least bothering. Compiler least bothering. So whenever runtime exception is occurring, whenever runtime exception is occurring, it is throwing to the, come on, to where it is throwing? to the line number 19. It is a part of that, right? It is a part of that, right? There is a catch. That catch is a runtime exception. Come on. That catch is a runtime exception. SOP of here. So please observe here. Small change. Inside a testimeter body, SOP of test, then there is an exception rising. Same raised one getting handled at line number 16. Observe this part. So please observe, whatever exception rising inside a body of the testimeter, same getting handled or not. It is not delegating to main method. Same getting handled in the testimeter body. Please go through testimeter body, everybody. Inside a testimeter body, try. There is an exception. After test, there is a runtime exception. Same runtime exception can be handled through catch. Line number 16, there is a catch. Getting handled, you'll get an exception. Test and exception, yes or no? In the testimeter body, whatever exception rising, same is getting handled. In the testimeter body, whatever exception is occurring, same is getting handled in the testimeter body only. In the testimeter body only. In the testimeter body only. Come on. See, in the main method, even though testimeter calling in the drive, there is no exception at line number 19. No exception at line number 19. This runtime catch will not be executing. The catch with runtime will not be executing. Please observe. This SOP of end will be executing. Remember here, test to method. Rising runtime exception. Same is getting handled in the body of the test to method itself. Rising runtime exception. How it is rising runtime exception? By using throw. In the body of the test method, throw new runtime exception. Come on. Throw new runtime exception. Same is getting handled in the body of the test method itself. In the body of the test method itself, it is getting handled. Why it is getting handled? There is a catch. Yes or no? There is a catch. In the body of the test method, exception rising and getting handled there itself. Caller of the test method, that is main method. At line number 19, there is no exception. Line number 20 will not be executing. Line number 21 will execute. Normal flow, line number 21 executing. Syntactically correct, compilation success, output will be test exception end. Sir, no. Test exception end. Line number 11. This is okay. Line number 11. Throws unchecked exception. It is just mentioning throws unchecked. Actually, this line number throws unchecked. Throws runtime is not required. It's very optional. Compiler is not at all bothering about throws unchecked. It is not like a throwing runtime. Why? Because in the body of the test method, there is no abnormal condition. There is no exception. But all, in the body of the test method, there is an unhandled exception, then only it will be throwing. Method is having a throws unchecked. That is not the meaning, like for all the callers it will be throwing. Remember this point. Method throws runtime exception. That is not the meaning, like it will be always throwing runtime exception to the caller. Check it out in the method body. In the method body, is there any unchecked, is there any unhandled exception? In the method body, if unhandled exception object is there, then only it will be delegated. Got it? Please observe. I'll clarify one more time. If method is throwing null pointer exception, method throws null pointer exception. It is not the meaning line for every caller of that method getting a null pointer exception. It is the meaning line inside a method body. If there is an unhandled null pointer exception object is there, that will be delegating. That will be delegating. So here, in the body of the test method, in the body of the test method, there is a try with a catch. In the body of the test method, there is a try with a catch. Try is there with a catch. Try is there with a catch. Come on. Try with a catch. In the body of the try, runtime exception is rising. Catch is there with exception. Same runtime exception getting handled through catch of exception. Yes or no? Test method executed successfully without any exceptions. Even though exception raised, same got handled. Once a test method execution got over, simply control coming back to main method, not with exception. Not with exception. Control coming to the line number 19. Line number 19 is not resulted with any exception. Because of that, line number 20 won't execute. Catch is not executing. Line number 21 will execute SOP of hand. Got it? Very good example. In the try body, inside a test method. Inside a test method, in the try body, there is a runtime exception through it. Same is getting handled in the body of the test method. Only to confuse you, they mentioned it test throws runtime exception. Test throws runtime exception. Only for confusing. So go to the 10th one. The 10th one. Try catch null pointer, catch runtime, then finally. So try first catch, second catch, then finally. It's also a kind of skeleton code. Line number 34 is a try block. Line number 36 is a first catch body. 38 is a second catch body. 40 is a finally body. What is the result if null point exception occurs on line number 34? If null point exception is occurring at line number 34, first catch will execute, second catch won't execute, finally will execute. You will be getting output as A and C, AC, AC. Option D is correct? Yes or no? Come to the 11th one. So 11th one, everybody, A is a global attribute here. Come on. A is a global attribute to foo class. Class name is a foo. Inside that foo, there is a array A. Come on. It is not initialized. If it is not initialized, it will be a null. Global attributes are null by default. Come on. So global attributes by default null. By default null. Yes or no? In the SIB, you are using A of square root 0. Sorry, square bracket 0. SIB. In the SIB, we are using A with a square bracket of 0. A is an array. Array not initialized. Array is a null. If array is a null, how you can use 0th index? If array is a something, not null, like a 0th index or 1 index is there, then you can refer. A is a null. From a null, you should not refer anything. From a null, while referring anything. from a null while referring anything. From a null while referring anything, you'll be getting null point exception. Say here, A is a null. You are referring 0th index in the A. A is a null. A is a null. You are referring 0th index in the A. 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 You supposed to get null point exception. But it is a part of the initializer. It is a part of the SIB. It is a part of the SIB. Same null point exception throwing as a exception initializer error. Please observe. If any exception occurring in the SIB, that will be throwing as a exception in the initializer. Exception in the initializer. Please remember. In the SIB, whatever it may be, the exception rising, it will be throwing as a exception in the initializer. Option C is correct. Come to the 12th one. Simple one. So come to the 12th one. Test method containing a try finally, then main method with a try catch. See, in the regular class, I forgotten to tell one point. So try with one catch is possible. Try with multiple catches possible. Try catch finally also possible. Try catch finally also possible. Fourth one, try catches and finally. Try catches and finally also possible. Fifth one, try finally. Try finally also possible. In case of try finally, everybody, we are not achieving exception handling. Exception handling purpose, we require either catch or throws. No catch, no throws here. Try it finally. But syntactically possible, it is not coming under exception handling. We are not handling the exception, we are not delegating the exception. So try with finally, what we are achieving is executing some mandatory statements through finally block. In order to provide a finally block, you required a try. Without a try, you cannot keep catches, you cannot keep finally. First one is a try. After try, you can go for catch, or you can go for catches, you can go for catch finally. You can go for catches finally, or you can go for just finally. Try with finally. If you wanted achieving some mandatory execution without worrying about exception handling, observe this point. Without worrying about exception handling, you are looking for executing some mandatory content. Executing some mandatory content that can be achieved through finally. Finally cannot be kept alone. That is why start with the try. Then finally. So most of the people are asking, is it possible to develop a try without catches? Is it possible to develop a try without catches? Absolutely possible, but finally is required. I repeat once again. Is there any possibility of developing a try without catches? I want to develop a try without catches. I want to develop a try without catches. Absolutely possible, but the try should end with the finally. Try finally. Try with finally, absolutely possible. You cannot keep try alone. You cannot keep try alone. You cannot give catch alone. You cannot give finally alone. First try should start. After starting a try, you can go for one catch or multiple catches or catch finally or catches finally or finally. Sir, no. So try alone not possible, catch alone not possible, finally alone not possible. You have to start with a try. After try, one catch or multiple catches or one catch finally or multiple catches finally or excellent. Enjoy karo. This is very, very important. We are not achieving exception handling here. Why? Because no catches. No handling. Only we are achieving executing some mandatory content. To execute some mandatory content, you have to keep final. You cannot keep finally alone. Try. After try, you can go for catch or catches. Catch or finally. Catches finally. Finally. Understanding? Now come back to our program. So here, try with finally is there. There is no catch. Most of the people thinking like it may be giving a compiled time error. So here, try finally, absolutely possible. In the body of the try, x is equal to null. X dot string, sorry, two string. Then in the finally, yes. Main method, giving a call to test method. Then exception, SOP of exception. See, this completely proper, syntactically proper, compilation will be very success. Compilation will be very success. Please observe, go through one more time. Test method. Main method. Test method, main method. In the body of the test method, try is there, finally is there. In the body of the main method, try is there, catch is there. Now here, control going to the test method. In the body of the test method, try is there, x is equal to null, SOP of x dot two string. You'll get a null point exception. Null point exception. Nobody is there to handle. Even though it is a part of the try, no catches. Even though it is a part of the try, no catches. Not getting handled. Flow supposed to terminate. That is, null point exception should throw back to line number 9. Yes or no? Yes, it is throwing to line number 19, but after finally block execution, executing finally block, then exception is coming to line number 19. Line number 19 is a part of the try. Line number 19 is a part of the try. Yes or no? That line number 19, part of the try, null point exception is propagated to line number 19. Same is getting handled through catch of exception. Yes or no? So what is the output?
Yes.
Understanding everybody? Finally and exception. Finally and exception. Whatever exception occurring in the test method, not getting handled. It is propagating to main method. But before propagating to main method, finally executing? Yes or no? Propagating to main. In the main method body, in the main method body, receiving exception, same is getting handled. Yes or no? So what is the output? Excellent. So go through line number 13.